What's up, YouTube? It's Disposable 762, and we're going to put these into these. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. What's up, YouTube? Just before the video starts, I'd like to promote my new t-shirt store at tpublic.com. At tpublic.com's website, if you go to the search bar and type in Disposable 762, you'll be able to find my t-shirt designs there. And I appreciate the business. I appreciate y'all watching these videos. I appreciate y'all subscribing. And I really would like to sell y'all some t-shirts, phone cases, stickers, whatever the case may be. You can select your different colors. You don't have to get these colors. You can get whatever color you want and sizes and women's sizes and stuff like that. These are just a couple of examples of my t-shirts that I figured I would come and show y'all. So I appreciate your business. I appreciate you watching the videos, and I appreciate your support. Remember, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and we're gone. So what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well. Today we're going to reload some 38s with some CFE pistol. We like the CFE pistol. It done real good with the Rossi in the 357 loads. But now we're going to do our 38 loads. So look at that, some data. Last night, we're going to do the 357s, and .5 grains. I know we said 6.4 in the video, but I don't think it's really going to matter. So we're going to do 6.5 grains of CFE pistol for 357, and we're going to do 5 grains. A CFE pistol for a 38. So we're gonna do some resizing and load up a few just to give it just to see how it's gonna do first off, and then we'll come back and determine if that 5 grains is good. So I've already set up the powder thrower. I think I have. Let's give a shot here. See if it's 5 grains. I might have to adjust it a little bit. .39. I'm a little off. .5 even. So we got our powder thrower set up at 5 even. So we'll set him aside until we get some shells ready. So we loaded up about 400 rounds. Well, we resized and primed about 400 rounds, and I started loading powder, and I forgot a step, but I want to show you what I found. Even though I have taken these rounds through a resizer, every now and again I still get that issue right there. And you can see the lead over the shell. It'll still shoot. The Ruger kind of don't like them because of the fitting into the chamber. But once you get it in the chamber, it'll shoot. But this is the fix. There's one I just loaded after I remembered what I needed to do. So like I said, after these have been resized, you need this tool here. Open it up a little bit. And there you go. fixes the problem. Now that one there, it's got a little bit hanging over, but you know, it's fine. It'll do just fine. But I wanted to share that with you because it stumped me for a while. You know, I'm new to this reload. Kind of new. I mean, I've got over 1,000 rounds under my belt, but still, you know, that ain't nothing compared to some of you guys out there. But that was my fix. That's what I found wrong with it. And I hope, you know, I hope that that little tidbit will help you all out.